Stage three, concept generation, is really one of the fun parts of the biodesign process. Once you have one or two or a handful of needs, the key is to really go wild and brainstorm. Really bring out the creative juices of the team and all of the members and the different backgrounds they bring.
This is a time to kind of let it fly, for lateral thinking, for rapid pace, get as many ideas going as you possibly can.
The brainstorming process can be a lot of fun. We typically try to encourage as wacky of ideas as possible, which is really exciting because nothing you say is ever wrong.
You have to really transition from this very critical headspace into a very open headspace.
We started brainstorming when we were down to four needs, and we set aside 2 to 3 brainstorming sessions for each of those needs. Out of each of those sessions, we'd come up with maybe 50 or 100 different ideas of how we could solve the problem.
To get pumped up for brainstorming, we had a lot of coffee. Some days we brought in cookies.
Lots of caffeine, lots of sugar, that's what you need.
We stood up, that was key for us.
1, 2, 3, grass!
We actually did a cheer early on to get us really fired up to brainstorm, so that helped. We did try and follow the general rules of brainstorming from the book.
For me, sometimes deferring judgment was really difficult because it's easy to see how things might not work.
Be free with what you think may solve a need, even if it makes no sense, because the idea is in a creative session, other people may build upon what you say.
I think one conversation at a time. So this is the most important.
There are different ways of approaching brainstorming. There's the well-mannered, build on the ideas of others. That works really well, especially if it's a team that's new to each other.
We did a lot of yes and. We made sure that we didn't shoot down our teammates' ideas.
But there are lots of different ways to do it. You can brainstorm on your own. You can brainstorm with a group of colleagues who are very critical, who will tell you when you're off track. All of these techniques work depending on the group, so you just have to figure out which kind is the best for you.
Our team found that a mix was good. Usually kind of the high level, all ideas are good ideas initially, was kind of a good way to get it started, but then kind of questioning and, you know, trying to dig into the details with a little bit more kind of a critical eye.
Before meeting for brainstorming, we used to understand the problem very well, and one of us would take a lead or would be a facilitator of a brainstorming session, and he would decompose a problem into different sub-problems, and then we will try to solve different sub-problems.
First, in the early brainstorming sessions, we just did our team. Later on, we brought in subject matter experts when we figured out where there are holes in our understanding of a concept or of a problem.
If you invite people from outside, they won't have that biased view of looking at the problem.
After a brainstorming session, we would record all of our data in a mind map, and then it's really easy to see where you focused in that session, and you can see holes. And so that was a good way to point us to where we should brainstorm more in the future.
So it's a little bit tricky to go from 100 ideas to try to figure out which you really want to investigate further to take forward. One touchstone is go back to your needs criteria. So look at what you specified that an ideal solution has to have and use that as an initial filter.
Most important for innovators to keep in mind is that even if they have some concepts that sound really fantastic and are very interesting, and that the team really loves, they should not go back and try to tweak or massage the must-have criteria or need statement to enable those concepts to go forward.
We compared all our concepts to these needs criteria, and from there we were able to get rid of a lot.
Our strategy became let the concepts compete against each other and try and identify weaknesses in the concepts so we knew which ones to spend our time on.
So hopefully after you compare against a need specification, your list of dozens or hundreds is narrowed down to a much smaller, more manageable number.